Some of you have been asking for a world tour. Well, here it is. If you remember what this is, where I'm at, then either you went behind and watched, or you've been here for a while. I was going to save this for a landmark video, like episode 50 or something, but seeing as I now have gained more than half my subs in the last, like, 3 weeks, I figure I might as well do it now. Ouch, that hurt. F5? There we go. So this is where it all started. This is a door that used to be there and then got blown up by a creeper and I haven't fixed it. This is just where I started out, just a little base. I still come back here to do my enchanting. As you can see, I still enchant quite a few things. Ooh. And down here I just have like a strip mine and that, which is blocked off so that guy doesn't go back to where his rightful home should be. And I just had some livestock in here. They're really annoying too, aren't they? Yeah, look at my FPS, like, cuts in half when I look at them. Anyway, then we just had some potatoes and wheat in here, and that's what we lived on. I had found this golden apple in a chest. So that was pretty cool. I don't know if golden apples are still as rare as they used to be, because they changed how much stuff is in chests and mines and stuff. Not sure on that. If you can't tell, or if you haven't noticed, I'm not using shaders this episode. Just because I figured, why not? I don't know. I'm going to be testing out whether people want shaders or not. Let me know, because I know some people really don't like them. I know some people really don't like the texture pack. Too bad. Actually, I picked this texture pack because it's pretty close to the original. Like, anything I build in this texture pack, oh, hello, frames, everything's rendering in. I probably don't need my renders this distance so high. Look at the sky change when I walk into the swamp. If I can get out of the swamp and show you. Anything that I build in this texture pack should... Can I not get out of the swamp? I just wanted to, I've already tried so hard to show you how different the sky looks. I guess this is just the way that the sky is going to look now. Unless, I don't think we're still in a swamp. Maybe we are. Over here? Here we go. That was still a swamp. Look at the sky change. Anything that I build in this texture pack should look pretty good in default texture pack. By the way, if you can hear a little kitten meowing, that's because there's a kitten meowing on the other side of my door, and I'm not sure how to get her to shut up. So this is the first town that we built, and was inspired, I shouldn't say built, because we're still working on it. I'm still going to have to come back to it at some point, and I still need more inspiration for it, because it's not quite done. And I teased this, I kind of showed this, I think the last episode, we were in the area doing some enchanting, and today I'll just do a more in-depth tour, though. But the idea came from, if you've played Skyrim, either Rift, like a cross of Riften or Lake Town from The Hobbit, where everything is real cramped, close quarters, really tall. So there would be tall buildings like this on both sides and you'd feel closed in. I never really did much with the interiors here. I did get this, a few of these buildings done though. It's just, I wanted it to look kind of dreary, but I think I did too good because it's all brown. Here's a bar that is not done yet either. Although I did do the kitchen back here a little bit. There's a gap right there. Look, I did the closet. I wonder if there's anything in there. Nope. Nothing. I didn't check one of them. I bet there's something in that one. A lot of these are like walkways built on top of houses and stuff. Just multi-tiered. Here's a little marketplace along with some sort of store right here, and there was, I put a storage unit back here. I thought that was pretty cool. Leave all the doors open. Instead of leaving it, hello words, instead of leaving it like you found it, leave all the doors open. Here's a cool little thing that I thought looked nice in this area. Putting windows, since there's like floors underneath and up, second tier walkways, put little windows there. You can see into the buildings, and it adds quite a bit. Let me sleep. I clearly didn't sleep before the video started. So how are you guys? I'm doing well. I'm cramming in a video skip class to get this video up. Don't tell my wife. It's just like freshman level political class. Not too worried. Over here, built some little homes. These look pretty good, I think. They're kind of boring, but they look pretty good. Then there's stuff like this one, where I tried different types of wood on the bottom and on the top. Then there's this one, which I've always thought looked... I think it's because the roof is lighter than the walls. It just doesn't look right to me. If you came here from my fireplace tutorial, though, you'll recognize this. This is a Baker furnace that I put in there. And then, yeah, so there's a lot to do here. I made these boats here, and if you want to know how to make these boats, I did make a tutorial on these. And, you know, I put some buildings over here. I think this was the last stuff that I did. These, like, walls right here leading to nothing. you can see that there's a jungle on the other side, and I've hinted that our next project may have to do with the jungle, and it, I think, is that biome that I've picked out. I did pick out this map specifically because of the biomes that were around. I think that is the jungle, and it's a huge jungle. If it's the same one I'm thinking of, I've got a picture of a map somewhere. I've got a little fire pit here. This building was like the last thing that I worked on. I like just didn't like it. I was like, I just needed something new, something to refresh myself. And that was the farming town. Ooh, there's something over there to look at. That was the farming town. That's what that's been for us. And that has been really fun for me. This farm town will be the first time that I've finished a proper town, like an entire town. Let's get over here. Here's like a logging area. So their thing over here is that it's kind of, they ship out wood that they get from this forest, I think was our idea. And they ship out, and that's what those boats are partly for that, and partly for importing hay, which gets stored inside that. I should probably show you that. Actually, there's no way up, is there? It's just hay, and that's where the farm town came into play. I was like, well, where's all this hay coming from? There's probably a farming town. And that's actually down the river. This goes that way and then bends that way and goes straight there. So this is a little area, just one of those things. I think it adds a lot if you add areas outside of your main builds for people that are looking at your world to just find. Not necessarily something they have to find, but if you just go wandering around and you find like two or three little outposts or something, you start to get that feeling like they're everywhere. You're like, how many of these things are there around? And it makes the world feel much more immersive. Yeah, that's the word. And you know, they only take like an hour or so to make those little tiny things. I have a few of them around. And I think they add a whole lot. I can spend that same amount of time doing like a couple houses in a town that nobody's going to think anything of. And by the way, I'm walking to the farm town. I'll cut in just a moment. But I do have something on the way there that I think I've only shown on camera once. That's my mob grinder. I found a zombie spawner just on the surface. I wish it was a skeleton spawner, especially now that we have the bone blocks. But it is not, so it's a zombie spawner. And it's nothing special. We sit down here, and I just have that closed off. Every now and then, I go AFK right here and close off, because every now and then, a little zombie does spawn right there. But it's on the other side. Let's just break through here. It's right there. Your basic spawner with water. I have a whole bunch of chickens down here just to kind of grind XP while I'm waiting for the zombies to load up. So I'll wait. There's a few of them there, but there's not a ton of them. I'll wait, and then I'll click this, and then I'll just hit them. And ooh, look, iron. I at one point had rigged it up so that it dispensed lava and then pulled it back. And then left him like one hit away from death, and I'm not sure how I screwed it up. Down there you can see where I sleep to get away from the mobs, so it lets me sleep. I'm not sure what I did, but at some point it was just like stopped working. So I was like, Well, I guess I'll just do it manually. You can see all the crap that I've gotten from it. And that's getting really annoying, so I'll see you at the farming town, which is down this way. We see the farm town coming into view. The first thing that we see, well, that lighthouse, which is not done. We got plans for over there, but I'll show you that in a moment. I'll show you what the first things I built were, kind of walk you along. I have plans for right here. I haven't really talked about them. I don't really know if I'm going to do what I had plans for, but that doesn't really matter. So I came here and, you know, the first thing that you gotta do when you have a new town is figure out a style. And that's where this house came in. I actually built it with, it's actually not even done. I forgot about that. I actually built it with System Z. I think he helped me out with it, or it was at least on his server and stuff. There's dirt there too. Wow. Good job, real professional. Did I do interior? Nope, of course I didn't. But this was, you know, the design that we were going to go with. And it was more of a prototype. You'll see that we didn't actually stick with exactly this style. I've never really thought about it. It is different from the rest of the houses. And we have wheat fields for days. And this is the second thing that we built, one of the landmarks, other than the Farmers Guild that you can see over there. This is like the landmark in this town, and I'm pretty proud of it. One thing I want to note, something I do, I put these walls at every change in elevation on these wheat fields, and I think it looks really nice. And I want to extend these wheat fields even more, but let's take a look at this windmill. So, pretty plain Jane. Pretty plain, like, right along here. But the redeeming qualities of it is that I screwed up. should that not... These tips are different, I think. I'm not sure. I think those blades are messed up a little bit. I'll have to crawl up there and count someday or something. But I really like this blade design, it being, you know, not up and down side to side, but rather this way. And there is actually a light up there for like a lighthouse type deal. I could fly up there if I went in creative mode, but I think I'll stay down here. This is how everything is supposed to be viewed. This is how I built everything with, you know, keeping in mind that someone would see it from down here. Down here is my favorite part about it, though. And it's like a... Is it just a stone mill? Is that what this is? Just a wheel turned by the windmill, and then you make like wheat or flour in this thing, right? So I think that's really cool. And you can come up here, and then, you know, once we get to the interior side of stuff in this town, perhaps we'll do something in here. Gotta get up to those lights somehow, I suppose, huh? One of the next things that I built that I think is probably one of the more eye-catching things if you're new here is this bridge. I quite like this bridge, to be honest. It's a nice round shape. You get a really good feel. Let's come over here. You get a really good feel walking over it and seeing the town come into view. Let's look at this real quick, though. I have plans over here to make some sort of dock, you know, export for wheat right here. And this is kind of like a template for it, what it's going to look like. And then we have the lighthouse for out there. And it needs an interior still. Needs a roof still. Needs everything still. As you can see, I love interiors. Let's go back to that. Let's go back to the bridge after I sleep, because the sun is going down and setting on us. Setting on the windmill. Get a good view of it every time that we sleep here. Onward! So you walk over this thing, and I built it with the thought that, you know, you walk over this and you're going to have everything revealed to you. There it is, the town, right? You see the wheat field, everything. I want, when you walk over this, basically everything golden on this side. maybe even over to there. Although really realistically with the walls that I do, I can't do it over here unless I like flatten out that hill, and I don't think I'm gonna do that. That always takes a lot longer than you think it's gonna take. So you walk down here and it's sort of the main road, and it splits off the main part of town, and you can see where everything's different here. Popular theme that I have here is that there's a stone first floor or basement floor, wood, and we didn't have that stone first floor on the prototype house. We've also got a chicken coop here that I actually really like. I'm still not sold on these corners, but I spent a lot of time trying to figure out why the heck this looks so bad. And then I put these doors on here to see these chickens through. Go inside and see what the other side looks like. And I was like, that's it. That's what we needed. And it's unique, I think. I don't know if anyone else has ever had that idea. You're in a bad spot, aren't you? And yeah, walk down here. This road is not complete, but I did map it out a little bit. You can see the Farmer's Guild. Over here, there's one of those little things I talked about being hidden. If somebody comes in here, they'll find that there is actually a secret tunnel. And it just kind of goes down to an underground lapis deal here. The idea was like drugs, like some crazy guy's got this secret here and he brews it up and then ships it out for money or enjoys it himself. I don't know. Nothing that we condone of. But he does it. It's his dirty secret. And back here, it's not too far back. You can see the back side of the Farmer's Guild right there. But over this hill is another one of those little things. I honestly wish I kind of put it a little further back, because I didn't know that I was going to build that at the time. But I made this campsite right here. And it's a nice little campsite. I really like this tent design that we came up with. Have these banners working as tent flaps or door flaps or whatever you want to call it. Ooh, there's, I'll take that and later, go through that later. Yeah, that's over here. We got some coal to do the fireplace. So, and that's like right behind that. It's just a campsite, no real story behind it. Let's go take a look at the actual town itself, though. We do have a pig pen right over here. And I'm not sure why. I think this is actually one of my like more viewed episodes. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe it's because of the muddy design. I used wood and coarse dirt and path blocks as mud and tildearth. And it looks really cool. It does. I do like how this looks. Use that. Go ahead and use that in your world. Got other, bunch of houses. I try to make them all different. I put this little workshop on the edge of this one. And, this one's got, what's this one got? This one's got storage underneath that stairwell. This one's got a first floor entrance and a second floor entrance. We come over here and you can see where I am working on. This is all going to be town. I've got a cow pasture over there. We can go look at that real quick. You can see how we've got extreme hills. I wish that there was more plains. This plains biome isn't huge, unfortunately. You can see I used a combination of rock, stone, and fence to keep them in. But I wish that this plains area was bigger, but it's all right. And this is the final thing that we have been working on. If you came from the wall tutorial, then you've seen this. The rest of you have seen my episode before I've seen this, I'm sure. Just a gated entrance that I really like. And yeah, we're still working on it. We've got some interior done. If we go over here, we've got the barracks. It's not necessarily a castle or any sort of military type deal, but it is a guild hall, you could call it. Here we have an archery range. I don't know about this wall. That wall might get replaced. I did do that tutorial on walls. This wall didn't make it into the tutorial, and there's a reason. I'm not too fond of it. Maybe if it were on a bigger scale. Before we go in, you know, we got this type deal, the fence lord in the ground. Stables over here. So the front is very inviting. It's got this gate, open courtyard. I mean, at the moment, it's open, I guess. And, you know, a place to take your horse and come in. It looks real nice. If you come over here, we do have some stuff on the side that I've done recently. I made this path going over here. Brought this wall up to the water, or rather brought the water up to the wall. And I put a storage unit over here. This is something that's going to have to get done soon. Really, the exterior of this building, all that's left is this corner, which might end up being another tower like these two. See how we do the flags here. And the roof, which comes down to space and floor planning and stuff. But yeah, we just got storage in here. The only one actually being used is this one. And the idea is that it's a bunch of seed stock. And yeah, like if there's a flood and the crops, the wheat field got wiped out, then if you didn't have a backup of seeds, you'd be SOL. And our town is prepared. So this is what we've got with the entrance. You know, this is right above that guard barrack, just for point of reference, a little closet. See, we've got an interior going, and it's the big thing that I'm working on right now. This is going to go up to a meeting room, not so much a throne room, not a castle, meeting room. You know, I've got a lot of things to work out still. This goes down to what we were just working out, a library, which is not done because I am very short on bookcases. I'm not sure that I like the way that they are anyway. We'll have to figure that out. Bookcases take a long time to harvest, though. I actually want to take a moment and look at this place in the default texture pack. See what it looks like. I bet that this building looks pretty good. Everything looks so flat. Yeah, the building looks decent. Let's look at the interior. It looks so flat. I'm used to shaders and a resource pack. It's very bright down here. A dark resource pack and shaders. Let's go look at the outside. I'm not sure how some of these houses will look. That birch doesn't catch my eye very well. I mean, it catches my eye. It doesn't do me any favors, though. It's kind of an eyesore. This all looks real nice, I think. I think that with the texture pack, or like the vanilla texture pack, if I were to have done all this in it, I would have considered maybe doing it all in, you know, mixing up wood types, just like we do with the the floor here. Hello, words. I think I would have done something like that. Especially this. This just looks way too clean. And you can tell, like, the backside of this needs something. This is so flat, needs a window or something, even right there. See, I'd do something like that there with different woods. It makes this look very flat. Maybe this just makes me realize how crappy of a builder I am. No, I hope you don't agree with that. But it looks decent in vanilla texture pack, especially stuff like this. I do like how this looks. Let's get back into what we are used to. And all of a sudden, everything... Oh, look, my little wheelbarrow. Everything looks much better. I bet even the backs of these walls look better than they do, actually. But I definitely think that this birch... If I were using a vanilla texture pack, I wouldn't be using birch in this area, I don't think, at all. I'd probably be using oak in place of birch, and like spruce or dark oak in place of the oak that I'm using now. Just like one shade darker on everything. But anyways, that is pretty much it. Get a really good view of the the windmill there. But, and you can see my tree farm. Yeah, the place is coming together pretty well. But yeah, that's about it that I have right now. I don't think I'm forgetting anywhere. But, you know, this place is winding down. Hopefully, we can, you know, finish this Farmer's Guild and then do some work on the town over here and the port or whatever we're going to call it. And then we're on to a new area and I have good plans and it's going to be more fantasy. Let's just say it that way. It's going to be bigger and badder than this. Yeah, bigger, better, fancy. Because this is all a themed world, kind of. I try to stick to, like, my own imaginary world. This is all happening in the same... So we're not going to be building, like, a modern town or anything. Because this is all in the same world. All in the same timeline. Maybe vastly different designs in different places. But for the most part... Nothing too wildly different as far as, like, modern stuff. So the jungle stuff will be, think temples or ruined temples and a new city on top of it. That's kind of where I'm going right now. But anyways, thank you for watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed the world tour. If you like this, then go back and watch. Warning, though, if you watch my, like, first like 15 episodes or something, I was really learning how to do this and finding my commentary voice, and I believe that I went quite a few episodes without realizing that I wasn't using my Nvidia card, so that was a little embarrassing. But so it's a little choppy too, so don't judge me too hard on those first few videos. But other than that, you know, keep up with me and keep watching these videos and leave a like and subscribe if you haven't. I appreciate it. Thank you. Bye.